Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing complex number. This is lecture number 3. I hope you have already watched part 1, part 2 before watching this part 3. So in this lecture, I am going to discuss about representation of complex number and modulus of complex number. So modulus of complex number, first I am going to discuss about the representation of complex number. We will discuss later on the argument and all, but till now I am writing here modulus of complex number. So in Cartesian system, if there is any complex number, say a plus iota b, if z is equal to a plus iota b and a and b are positive, then on x-axis and y-axis, this can be represented as, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. This one is called a real axis. A real axis because it will represent a real number. And this one which is called imaginary axis. Imaginary axis because it will represent imaginary number. And of course, this is an origin. So, if modulus of complex number, suppose a is the distance here and b is distance there, then if I can write like this is b, say b, and there is an a like this, if this distance is described as a and b, this one is a and this distance is b. Right? So, let me write this. If I can write here, this is a and this one is b. Right? So, this distance is like this. So this point is P, and P is represented as A comma B or A plus iota B. Right now, what is A here? Here A is there. A is this distance along the real axis. P is a number which can be represented as P is a point. This point is called P, which can be represented, and this is A, and this one is B. So A comma B. Now this P is representation of represent Z that can be written either in form of A comma B or A plus iota B. Modulus of Z is what? So modulus of Z is the distance of this fx that is called fx, not point, because it has been fixed. Imaginary axis is there that has been also an from imagination. So this distance is called OP, is called modulus of Z. OP is called modulus of Z. So modulus of Z is nothing else but OP. Since this distance is B and this distance is J, so using Pythagoras theorem, if I can write this M, then OM plus square plus PM square is equal to, what will happen? OM square by Pythagoras theorem. OP square is equal to OM square plus PM square, and OM is nothing else but A square plus B square. So if I am writing OP, then OP is equal to A square plus B square. And what is OP? OP is described as modulus of Z. OP is nothing else but modulus of Z, and that will be under root A square plus B square. So in fact, modulus of Z is what? modulus of a complex number is nothing else but the distance from origin to the fx. P is called fx. P is fx. And so modulus of complex number is nothing else but distance is the distance of fx. Literally you can say, just for understanding, as a point, but it is not point, because point has a real representation and fx has not a real representation. Distance of fx from origin, right? Thus we can say, if z be any complex number, of form a plus iota v, then this implies modulus of z is equal to a square plus b square under root. That is real part ka square plus imaginary part ka square. If it is a minus iota b, then also it will be, modulus of z will be a square plus b square. Minus b whole square, that will be b square. A square plus minus b whole square, and this is under root, which will be again a square plus b square. So one characteristic is there, that mod of z, if z is equal to a plus iota b, then z conjugate is a minus iota b, and modulus of z square is also equal to a square plus b square, and modulus of z conjugate square is also a square plus b square. And in this way, from these two, we can say z conjugate square and modulus of z square both are same. We also know the z into z conjugate is equal to a plus iota b. We have learned this in last lecture, that will be a square plus b square. So from first, second and third, we can say that z into z conjugate is equal to modulus of z square is equal to modulus of z conjugate square, and all are equal to a square plus b square. So this is one thing which you need to remember, I think so. Right? Okay. So this one you need to remember, z into z conjugate. Z is there, z conjugate is there, and then modulus of z into z conjugate will be this. So modulus of z is nothing else but the representation of the distance actually from origin to that point. Distance from origin to that fx. And fx is what? Because it is a real as well as imaginary numbers. And x's are also real and imaginary x's. So we will later discuss about the Argand plane and Argand diagram. Then we will consider about the argument and amplitude as well. But till now, just modulus of complex number is what? That is the distance. Now, if there is a complex number and its conjugate both has to be represented, then what will happen? Let us draw. This one is x axis, x dash, y and y dash. So if a plus poach z is equal to, I am taking 2 plus 3 iota, right? Then z conjugate must be 2 minus 3 iota, isn't it? And in that case, let me write, because x axis is longer and y axis is shorter, so I can write it. Z is equal to 3 plus 2 iota, and z conjugate must be 3 minus 2 iota. So x is 3 and y is 2. So 3 and 2, where it will come? x is 1, 2, and 3. Here is there. And 1, 2 is this point. So the point will be here only, isn't it? And that will be z, that is 3, 2, or 3 plus 2, both way we can write. This is, say, P. So P is a point there. And P dash will be 3n minus 2. So the line will be like, this one, and that will be P dash. Say this is 1 and 2. So P will be, line will be here. One more line will be. Right. So here it will be P and P dash. P dash is there, and that will be 3, minus 2 or z conjugate. So the distance of these two will be same. Distance of these two will be same. Take it like distance from here to this one is a z. Distance of z conjugate is this, isn't it? And distance of z conjugate is also this. Both are equal to same. So graphically you can understood it how this will be z and z conjugate are numerically equal, you know. So we can have like this. This is what. Right. So z and z conjugate are there, and I hope you got it. How to deal with this? This will be. These are the points, and this will be also. So this is z and z conjugate. So that is the distance which is represented as z, and this is the distance which is represented as z conjugate, and both are numerically same. So I hope you got it. Z and z conjugate are numerically same. And the points can be represented like this. Okay, so now we will see some more characteristics of this complex number. Now let me explain polar representation of complex number. Another characteristic is polar representation of complex number. That is polar representation. Representation of complex number. Complex number. Polar representation. What is that? The representation which has been expressed in terms of Cartesian system, that is A and B, that is being basically described as Cartesian form representation. Cartesian form. So now what about the polar form? Polar form is nothing else but a representation of complex number in terms of r and theta. So if I am writing complex, representing any complex number in terms of r and theta, then that will be considered as polar representation. So say this one is polar representation, and this is y axis, this is x axis, what, and this is origin. So this is imaginary axis, clearly. This is an imaginary axis, and this is real axis. Now suppose a complex number is represented as in form of like this. Here is A and B. this is a complex number represented, and complex number is P, that is A plus iota B. So Z is a complex number represented by P, that is A plus iota B. Now, if we draw two mutually perpendicular lines from here, then you know this one is called this one along represented along which one? Imaginary axis, so it is an imaginary number. So that is B and that is A. And this angle which is made here, that is theta. So this angle is theta. Theta is made here from. So theta is made like this, anticlockwise direction. Okay. So if this modulus of Z, this distance is described as R, say R, then by geometry sine theta is equal to perpendicular B upon R, and therefore B is equal to R sine theta, right? And A is equal to cos theta is equal to A by R, and therefore A is equal to R cos theta. So here A and B can be described in terms of theta, isn't it? And AZ is equal to A plus IB is polar representation. What is R? R is nothing else but modulus of Z, and that is equal to A square plus B square. So what about theta? Tan theta is described as B by A, and theta is described as tan theta is equal to B by A, right? So this, if Z can be written as A plus iota B, that is called Cartesian representation, Cartesian form, right? And in place of A, if I would write here R cos theta, and in place of B, if I will write R sin theta, R cos theta and R sin theta, R sin theta, then it can be further written as R, I can take common, cos theta plus iota sin theta, and that is called polar representation, polar form. So this is a polar representation. Z can be written in form of R cos theta plus iota R sin theta, where R is and A square plus B square under root, and tan theta is B by A. Now for theta, theta may be lie in first quadrant, may be lie in second quadrant, may be lie in third quadrant, and may be lie in fourth quadrant. So for theta, there is a specific notation. We have like a this is x axis, this one is x dash, this one is y, and this is y dash. This is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this one is called fourth quadrant. Everybody know this. If A and B both are positive, then lies in first quadrant. If A is negative and B is positive, then lies in third quadrant. If both are negative, then lie in third quadrant, and A is positive and B is negative, then lie in fourth quadrant. A is what? The real part, and B is what? Imaginary part. So it must be clear. The angle between 0 to 2 pi is described as amplitude of complex number. So that theta is called, this theta is called amplitude of complex number. This one is called amplitude of complex number. Amplitude of complex number. Amplitude. Or argument. Argument of complex number. Of complex number. Right? This one is called amplitude or argument. theta is called amplitude or argument of complex number. So here, that is why this whole diagram is called Argand diagram. This diagram is called Argand diagram. Argand diagram or Argand plane, even Argand diagram, or even called Argand plane, right? This is called Argand plane. So it means if z is written like a plus iota b and a and b both are positive, then the complex number lies in first quadrant, isn't it? And if complex number is lies in first quadrant, then angle must lie between 0 to 90 degree. If z is lies here, suppose, then angle must be more than 90 because this is the initial axis. And angle must lie between more than 90 but less than 1. Suppose z is here, in that case, z is there, in that case angle must lie between angle lie must between more than 90 but less than 180. So z is here, then in that case the angle will be from this one, you know, this one, this will be the angle. Similarly, if lies here, then that angle will be also, but it will be from this direction, it will be quite a smaller value. So here, if z lies in third quadrant, then instead of measuring like this angle, we can measure from this direction as well. And this direction angle is negative. So of course, the principal value of z lies between pi, minus pi to pi. Pi means 180 degree from this side to here, and from this side it will be minus 180. So principal value of argument here, one statement I can write, principal argument of a complex number lies between minus pi to pi. Minus pi to pi. Remember this fact. Principal argument lies between minus pi by 2, pi to pi. There will be four cases, and you can remember this. Let me draw a table and what will happen on the basis of this. So there will be suppose z be any complex number and z is equal to a plus iota b, a minus iota b. Z is equal to here, z is equal to a plus iota b. The next one is z is equal to, say a and b are positive. I have supposed it that a and b are positive, a minus iota b, z is equal to minus a plus iota b, and this will be less. So say if z is equal to a plus iota b, a is here positive, a is positive, and a is positive, b is also positive, right? Then lies in first quadrant, and argument of this will be theta. Argument of z will be theta, is theta. Argument of z is theta. In that case, argument of z is theta. If z is equal to minus a plus iota b, then this is a is negative, this one is positive, lies in second quadrant, and argument of z lies in second quadrant, that will be pi minus theta. If z is minus a minus iota, in that is both are negative, so lies in third quadrant, and in that case argument of z is minus pi plus theta, where theta is always acute angle, and that is given by, and z is equal to minus a plus iota b. In that case, this one is positive, a is positive and b is negative, so lies in fourth quadrant, and in that case argument of z is minus theta, where theta is always, what we have assumed, theta is taken as, where tan theta is taken as, tan theta is modulus of b by a, and therefore theta is always an acute angle, an acute angle, acute angle. So that is why if I subtract from pi minus theta, it would be an obtuse angle, but we will assume it as an acute angle, and we will always use modulus. Whatever the negative and positive sign, while calculating theta, we will use it as positive value. So we have to represent them. Argument of a complex number in form of representing in polar form, we need two things. One is r and another is theta. So r and theta, this is the form which is called polar form. This form is called polar form, right? So I hope you got it. Now some questions are to be taken for consideration. Yes. So now some questions I am going to take on from the exercise which is given, and let me solve them one by one, right? So what is the question? Exercise 5.2, and it is given that find modulus and argument of, modulus and argument of each of the following, each of the following complex number, complex numbers, right? Each of the following complex numbers. There are two complex numbers given, and we have to find modulus and argument of complex number. First question is given that z is equal to minus 1 minus iota. Z is minus 1 minus iota. This is a polar representation. We can write as minus 1 minus iota is equal to r cos theta plus iota r sin theta, right? So in school, we have to write, let this is equal to in polar form, and equating, we will write it step by step, equating real and coefficient, imaginary coefficient, imaginary parts, both the sides. Means real can be equal to real only, r cos theta is equal to minus 1, and r sin theta is equal to what? R sin theta imaginary part is equal to minus 1 also. Iota, no need to write, just comparing the coefficient. So in that case, both are negative, and if squaring and adding, you can write this is 1 and 2. So on squaring and adding, squaring and adding, you will find it r square cos square theta plus sin square theta, you know that is 1, and that will be minus 1 whole square, that is 1, and plus 1 square is 2. So r square is equal to 2, and therefore r is equal to root under 2. So value of r is obtained. Now second divide by first, you will write here. When second divide by first, divide second by first, we will have r sin theta divided by r cos theta is equal to minus 1 divided by minus 1. That will be tan theta is equal to modulus of 1. If I will take both are negative, but theta can be, since both are negative and therefore it lies in which quadrant? Tan theta is modulus. Since both are negative, so since z lies in third quadrant, z lies in third quadrant, and tan theta is given by modulus of this, right? 1/1, that is 1. So theta is equal to 45 degree, right? Theta is just 45 degree because both are taken as negative, and so it will be theta is 45 degree coming. So tan theta is 45 degree. Theta is 45 because both of them, theta can be calculated by using modulus of this. So theta is, tan theta is modulus of this, and it is 45 degree, pi by 4. But argument of z is, that is theta. Argument of z is theta, is z, that is theta is equal to pi minus pi plus pi by 4. You should not write this step, this is just for understood, right? And here you write minus pi plus theta. What I suppose to write here, that minus pi plus theta is an argument, and theta is always taken as absolute value of this. So minus pi plus theta is minus 3 pi by 4 minus what? Minus 3 pi by 4. Now from first, minus 1 minus iota is equal to r cos theta, r that is root 2, cos theta, r cos theta, theta is minus 3 pi by 4, and plus r sin theta, r I have taken common, isn't it? We can write it, let me write whole thing, then definitely I'll write r cos theta plus iota r sin theta, isn't it? And you may take it as r cos theta plus iota sin theta, isn't it? And therefore r is nothing else but root 2, and cos theta is minus 3 pi by 4 plus iota sin theta is minus 3 pi by 4, isn't it? You know, cos minus theta is cos theta, cos minus theta is cos theta. So it will be cos 3 pi by 4, but sin minus theta is minus sin theta. It is sin 3 pi by 4, sin 3 pi by 4, isn't it? Cos 3 pi by 4 and minus sin 3 pi by 4. Minus sine 3 pi by 4. Sine minus theta is minus sine theta. And cos minus theta is cos theta. So minus 1 minus iota can be written as root 2 times cos 3 pi by 4 minus iota sine 3 pi by 4. And that representation is called polar form. Polar form. Right? This is the polar representation of the complex number. That is minus 1 minus iota. Now the next question is given here, that is second part of the question, z is equal to minus root 3 plus iota. So modulus of z can be calculated as under root minus root 3 whole square plus 1 square, that is 3 plus 1, which is 4, and the square root of 4 is 2. So modulus of z is 2. In previous question also they were asking for modulus and argument only, but I have represented this in polar form. If someone want to find modulus and argument, then they can write modulus of z is equal to under root minus 1 whole square into minus 1 whole square, and that is under root 2. And argument, if someone want to write, then they can write tan theta is equal to minus 1 upon minus 1, that is b by a, we have know that tan theta is E by A, and modulus of Z is under root A square plus B square, and therefore, since both are negative, theta is equal to minus pi plus pi by 4, that is minus 3 pi by 4, and that's all in this question. We can write only these two things, and that will be more than enough to write the answer of this question. But since there is a less question in this topic, so I have represented this bill also in polar form, and that is useless for this question, but that will be good for practice as well. So that is why I have represented. In next question, since you know that how to represent in polar form, I am writing here modulus and argument only. So modulus is this, and argument of z will be given by tan theta is equal to what? b by a, and what is b here? 1, and what is a here? Minus root 3. So b is positive and a is negative, so clearly z lies in second quadrant, and therefore theta will be what? Theta is equal to pi minus, if I will take positive value, then 1 by root 3 is the value of pi by 6, tan pi by 6. So pi minus pi by 6, that is 5 pi by 6. So argument of z is theta, and that is equal to 5 pi by 6. So that will be more than enough. And if someone want to ask you to represent this also in polar form, then you can represent, put the value of r and theta, and you will get it. I hope you got it. So in this way, you will solve the rest of the questions which is given in exercise. If you will be not able to solve it, we will discuss in the next class and after the break. So till then, bye bye. God bless. Keep watching and subscribe this channel if you haven't subscribed yet.